Good morning, everyone, and welcome to another live with Scientist Molly. I'm so excited to be back with everybody this morning. We'll give everybody a few minutes to join us. I hope you're all having a great Wednesday morning and are excited to do some fun science experiments with me this morning. We will be building our own DIY bottle rockets this morning for the 4th, which I'm very excited about. We will, of course, be using our awesome combination of vinegar and baking soda, which we have learned in previous live experiments can have a quite explosive combination. So, before we get started, of course, let's start with all of our traditional things that some of you guys are very used to at this point, and some of you may be brand new and just joining us, which, hello and welcome, and I'm so glad that you're here. My name is Molly Miller, and I'm an outside recruitment manager for the North Carolina Peaks to Piedmont Council. We serve 40 counties in North Carolina, from the western to the Piedmont area, central Piedmont area. And we have lots of awesome things going on right now. We have virtual badge programs. We have a Mom and I program going on. We have events for you to bring a brand new friend if you're already a Girl Scout, as well as a awesome program just for adults called Take a Break, so you guys can take a break with us and get some awesome programming. And you can find out about all of these online at www.beagirlscout.org, which my awesome chat box buddy. Darn it, I messed it up again, you guys. I messed that up last video too. I don't know why it always gets me. June will drop that in the comment box below so you have that quick link. Also, don't forget, we are doing some incredible things at camp right now. So if you are interested in an awesome camp experience, because yes, camp is not canceled this year. We are still having a camp experience no matter what. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Amanda. Good morning, June. Hi, Lisa. I've got some awesome people joining me. You can check out our camp programs at www.camplikeagirl.org. They're doing some pretty cool things, guys. You totally want to check those out. Okay, so with all of those wonderful things out of the way, let's talk about how to build our own bottle rockets. So, first thing we need is a 2-liter. So today we'll be building the USA Minute Maid Lemonade, because that's my 2-liter I got hanging out. So a 2-liter will do. You can take the wrapper off if you want to. I just didn't get a chance, and that's okay. The next thing we're gonna need is a cork. You may have a little trouble finding this, so ask Mom and Dad some assistance. They may have something that has a cork in it, and they may be able to supply one for you, but you're gonna need a cork. The cork is gonna go in the top of the 2-liter. So that's actually the very first thing we need to do. We're gonna cork our 2-liter. This is very important. So the next thing we're gonna need is 3 unsharpened pencils. Now, I know all of you guys probably have that extra school supplies laying around. Do you guys like school supplies? I have a really big love of school supplies. This used to be my favorite time of year, was when we got to go back to school shopping for school supplies. It's the best. I love to buy new binders and new pencils and new folders. It's my favorite. Thank you, Leah. I love my lab kit too. It's my special lab coat. Makes me feel very scientist-y. I have all kinds of crazy costumey things in my house. So, okay, anyways, so our 3 pencils. And then we're gonna need either duct tape or packing tape or something that's gonna hold our pencils to our bottle. Ugh, and of course I can't find the end of my packing tape. Do you guys ever have that problem? Do you ever have the issue where the end of the tape hides from you? I do sometimes. You know, a good trick is to turn over the end of the tape, just fold it over so you don't lose it. Obviously, I didn't think about that the last time I used my tape. Okay, ha, I got it. There we go. All right, so I'm gonna cut just a little piece of my packing tape, and I'm actually gonna go ahead and cut 3 pieces because I know I'm gonna need them. I'm just gonna set them aside. One is gonna be for each pencil. There we go. And I'm going to be kind to future Molly, and I'm going to fold over the end of my tape so that I can find it later. All right, so we're going to set that aside. Now, here's what we want to do. So we're going to take our bottle, and we're going to flip it over and put it down on the counter in the space we're working on, okay? Because we want to know where our cork stops. And what we're going to do is we're going to take our pencils, eraser side down, and we're going to line them up so they're even with our cork on our bottle. And that is where we're going to tape our pencils to our bottle. And this is basically, we're building the landing pad on our rocket. So this is what makes them stand up. Okay. And we're going to do this 3 times. And your pencil may not sit completely flat against your bottle, because you know soda bottles have all kinds of like grooves and bunches. And excuse me, I have apparently had a little bit of water in my bottle. I'm gonna wipe up my surface really quickly, because you know a good science surface is very important. Okay, so we're gonna do one there, we're gonna do one on this side, because we've got to have a good stable platform for our rocket. And as you can see, we don't have that yet. And that's what we want to build. And you could use 4 if you wanted to. I just think 3 is a good number. I'm gonna lay it on its side to do this now that I have the right dimension and length that I need. Oh, my tape got twisted, guys. Okay, and one more. Check my stance here. Yep, there we go. That's perfect. Flip it down. And there we go. So we have our basic rocket built. And as you can see, it now stands up by itself, which is what we were going for. Okay, now we have to fuel up our rocket. So we're gonna flip it back over. We're gonna remove our cork, and then we're gonna add our rocket fuel. So we're gonna take our handy dandy funnel that we often use. You guys know, I love my funnel. And we're gonna need 2 cups, so I have an awesome 2-cup measuring cup here, of vinegar. So I'm gonna measure out my 2 cups of vinegar. Oh, and this is brand new vinegar, so I've gotta open it up here. I went ahead and bought the really big bottle because we're gonna be doing a couple experiments with vinegar this week. Because as I promised, we like things that blow up. All right, so 2 cups. Woo, smell that vinegar. Vinegar has that special smell, doesn't it? Quite potent. Some people really like that smell. All right, and we're gonna pour it using our funnel into our rocket. Okay. So, now you're probably asking me, okay, Molly, if we just pour baking soda directly into that, you're suddenly just gonna get an explosion. So how do you make a delayed reaction so you can actually set off your rocket? Well, I have a solution for that. So here's what you do. Ooh, a little more spillage there. I like to grab a tissue. So, you know, just a common around the house tissue. You could also use toilet paper, it works just as well. And I take my tissue. And you need 2 tablespoons of baking soda. So I'm gonna grab my handy dandy tablespoon and my handy dandy baking soda. And I'm gonna put that baking soda right in the middle of that tissue. One tablespoon, 2 tablespoons, excellent. All right, put that aside for cleanup here in a little bit, because as you all know, we always have to have a nice clean sciencey space. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I'm actually just gonna kind of push all of this to the center, and I'm gonna make just a little tissue pocket with my baking soda. Okay. Tissue pocket. So what's gonna happen is in just a few minutes, I'm actually gonna sign off with you guys, and I'm gonna go outside and I'm gonna set off this bottle rocket. So watch for an additional video in the comments, because then you'll get to see my rocket set off. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this and you'll put it just in the top. And you may have to adjust your size. I think I put a little too much in my center. So just adjust it. That's okay. You wanna make sure it fits in the top of the bottle. That's the key part. And if you have too much baking soda, you just use a little bit less. There we go. That's better. Fold my edge. Okay, we're gonna prime our rocket. So, once I drop this in, I'm gonna pop my cork and we're gonna see what happens. So, make sure you come back and watch in the comments to see my video of my bottle rocket being set off. I can't wait to see what happens. Also, don't forget to join us at 11 again on Friday and for our wellness event tomorrow at 4. And I'll be joining you again on Friday, and we'll be doing bubbling bags. Can't wait to see you guys then. And have some fun making your own bottle rockets. I've been Scientist Molly, and I will be right back with you guys in video. Talk to you soon.